Hello fellow tankers, bonjour amis tankistes. In this video, I will present you a detailed tutorial on the new map Aral Sea, followed by two gameplays. The first one in Tier 7, played from the south side. It was a long time since I've presented a gameplay in Top BR. And the second gameplay will be played in Tier 3 from the north side. So I really love this map, especially compared to some recent maps like Spaceport or Red Desert, which I find really absolutely uninteresting and badly designed. This map is beautiful first, graphically beautiful. You don't have copy pasta of some parts of the buildings or church or concrete fences, which are copy pasted from maps to maps. Sometimes it's a bit absurd. Here the decor is completely original and pretty beautiful. And the second reason why I love this map is that it's a map where very few very active players can have a huge impact and essentially carry the battle, as you will see, especially in the first gameplay. So this map is an horizontal map, as I call them, in the sense that the three caps are at equal distance from the two pair of spawns. And very often on this kind of maps, and know that I'm repeating myself, but you have two connected caps and one isolated cap, sorry. So on this map, it's almost a caricature, in the sense that these two caps are so connected that in fact you should almost consider them as a single cap. It's very rare that at the end of the battle, a side gets B and the other side gets A. Generally, the same side will get A and B and will ultimately win the battle, which tells you that it's completely useless to go to C. C is another battle in some alternate parallel universe, and going to C has simply 0.0 impact on the outcome of the battle. So I will not talk about the fight on sea. I guess it's not so difficult. I guess that going from one boat carcass to another and ultimately to sea should not be so easy, so that I cannot understand why people are camping so far from sea all the time. But anyway, I'm not interested in the combat on sea because it's simply irrelevant. So on this map, my advice is that you actually start from B, because B plays a huge role in this battle. Obviously, first, if you cap B, you have already capped a zone, which is obviously important. But from B, you can flank A from both sides, or even take positions which will prevent enemies from getting to A, or even from coming to B. For instance, if you occupy these corners, so from here you can cover this area, and from here you can cover this area. Although this area is a bit better protected for the blue side. But as you will see in the second gameplay, from B, and especially and only, I would say, if your team is really controlling the area between A and B, and has control A, from B you can also go along this platform, or whatever you call it, to snipe at sea in a quite ridiculous way. There is a little bit of cover on this line, not so much, so you have to be still a bit careful, and you'd better have a little bit of Gun Depression, but as you will see, you will have a perfect view over all the battlefield around sea from here, and which will ultimately make all the tanks fighting around sea extremely vulnerable. But again, only snipe at sea if the situation is well controlled in A and B. So we will move to the to gameplays where I will give you some other tips, and I really advise you to watch them because the two of them are actually pretty nice and very active. As always, I'm also encouraging you to support this channel by subscribing if you didn't do it yet, and by firing a few likes to the video that you enjoy, hopefully this one. So it's been a long time since I've shown a gameplay in top tier, in tier 7, and I'm playing my American lineup, starting with this M1A2, which is speeded, but I am grinding the new M1A1 HSC. And I'm going toward B. And here, let me mention something quite important that I didn't mention in the tutorial part. Let me stop briefly. If you go to B, don't go this way, the shortest way here, because as you will cross here, you will very often have a few tanks on the opposite line, and you will be very often sniped while crossing. And you see that's the same from the other side. So my advice from the blue side, it takes just a bit longer, but actually not so much longer. Go a bit further to the east, and then cross toward B. And my advice is that you do the same from the red side. So don't cross directly here, but cross here. And very often you will see that people attack B from the west side, and by coming from the east side, you will often propose a new shooting angle, original shooting angle, which will pose a lot of problems to the enemy, which will be probably focused on your squad ma teammates attacking from the other side. So here I wanted to cap directly. I'm a bit surprised by this Bradley. I admit that I have no idea where my shot went. Maybe I missed him. But anyway, unfortunately, he's firing missiles which can fuck you from the top. Pardon my French. And I'm wrecked. So let me accelerate while I'm repairing and recovering, I think. And now we are attacking my squadmate Pop Chisel from this east side. I missed my shot here, but Pop is finishing this Chinese tank. Here I'm a bit surprised by this Leopard 2A6, and I'm wrecked again on the cap. So it's a difficult start for me, but as you will see, that will get better very shortly. So let me accelerate while I'm capping. And I'm going back to the east. So you notice that most of our team spawn to sea. And here I'm actually stopping briefly to write in the chat, "Stop spawning to sea." Don't worry, they will not listen to me. As you can see on the map, we are only five in our team, including the three players from our squad. fighting for A&B. My other squadmate, Filbert, a quiet man, which has been featured in many other videos, has captured A, but is struggling and will ultimately lose A. So here, unfortunately, Pop is stuck to my tank and and I'm struggling to aim at this Leopard 2A4 because of the vibration due to his tank. No, I'm advancing. The idea is to try to occupy this corner over there, where you can actually prevent new tanks to come to A, and obviously also to B. Here, the same one A1HC that I'm grinding right now is wandering. Shot at it. So here, unfortunately, my reload is extremely slow because I have only two crew left. So my advice, when you shoot an M1 Abrams, if you have enough penetration, shoot on the lower plate, but otherwise shoot in the turret ring, where even a tier 2 tank can kill an Abrams. And you will kill it. Unfortunately, here I was not reloaded, and this T-80 kills me. My death will be a very good opportunity to visit A, since Filbert was killed there, and the last ally on A will be killed in a few seconds. Unfortunately, I'm not fast enough to save it. Therefore, I'm wrecking this Leopard 2A5. And again. And ultimately, I kill it. Unfortunately, I'm not reloaded yet. But this Chinese MBTs only kills my driver. Here in third view, in third person view, I see this IPM1. And I wreck him, and ultimately I killed the three tanks which were around A. So here, in the excitation of the moment, I'm a bit lost. I want to go to Cap A, especially since I'm grinding this M1A1, new M1A1. I'm a bit lost. I say, what the heck? Oh yes, sure. A is on my left, so here I'm taking a huge risk to cross. So when you attack A, my advice is obviously you can come from the west, but my advice is actually to attack A from behind A, or actually going a bit. Let me take just a break here and take an aerial view. So obviously you can try to attack a bit from the west side, where you have a bit of cover from both sides. But I actually like using also the terrain to come from behind the cap, where obviously you can also exploit the cover of the central church. And the interest of coming a bit from the behind the cap, or the east in the sense, is that you will reduce the angle from enemy tanks which will shoot in this direction after capping B, for instance, and which would have a very good shooting angle over tanks which are a bit further. So obviously, again, when you have capture B, you can come, for instance, here in this position again, that I have just mentioned. You can come along this wall here to shoot in this direction and to cover A, and you can do that from both sides. So here I'm going back across between A and B, which can be obviously quite dangerous, but which I've done quite a few times because I saw one of my ally die on B, and I was a bit worried that we would lose B. As you can see, some people are still respawning to C, staying camping over C. So here I'm struggling a bit to kill this Tunguska because I'm aware that there is a Leopard 2A6 on the other side of this wall. I don't really know if he has the possibility to rush me. As you can see, again on C, the people there are essentially now staying in the spawn. And like on several maps like Fulda, Tunisia, Korea, where C is completely isolated and C essentially has no interest and is completely useless. Unfortunately, the people fighting on C very often are not the best of your team. But really on this map, it's really almost a caricature in the sense that C is absolutely, totally, totally irrelevant. And my advice is simply fight for AFB and especially concentrate on B. So at this stage, obviously, the battle is almost finished. And I'm trying just to wreck a few last kills. Particular this T-80. Unfortunately, the battle is finished and I will not have the time to kill another tank. As you can see, our squad had a good impact. Obviously, we had quite a few kills, but as you can see, we had also a big impact in terms of caps, while probably, unfortunately, the players with the least impact were the one fighting for C in some alternate parallel universe. So now let's move to the gameplay played from the other side. So I am playing my BR5.7 Chinese lineup, essentially a Russian lineup. And American legend, actually. And playing from the north side, and again, I'm going toward B. Let me accelerate. And this gameplay will illustrate the good view that you have over C once you have capped B. So here you see I'm crossing directly to B. I guess because I didn't see any red tanks, but honestly, and the crossing is a bit faster from the blue side. But my advice is that try to come a bit more to the east. Actually, one of the reasons I crossed directly is that I could see that I had a lot of support behind me. So obviously this battle started in a much nicer way than the previous one, because as you can see, obviously our squad is fighting on A and B. I mean, almost all our squad, but also a lot of other players in my team are fighting for A&B, so at this point I already knew that we would win the game. So I'm keeping this T-44, but I can tell you that now I'm I will be much more careful when coming to this area, because as you can see, let me show you, that's something that you have to be a bit careful when you are approaching these angles over there, and similarly over there, is that you can be sniped from quite far away. So here obviously I was a bit careless and I paid for it. So I'm taking the second T-34 85 that you find in the Chinese lineup, whereas the Russian lineup has only one. There is also a premium T-34 for the Russian and a premium T-34 for the Chinese, so the Chinese have actually three T-34. Here you see that this time I'm crossing completely to the east to go to B. No, I'm actually not going to B. I'm going to illustrate the nice view that you have from this area toward the enemy, I'm sorry, toward the area around C. So obviously here I'm a bit hampered by my bad gun depression on that you have on this T-34 85. And here I'm taking a bomber, let me accelerate a bit. So you see that the big error of the enemy team was to concentrate so many resources on the seaside. I'm bombing two enemy tanks. Here I don't have enough gun depression. Yes, here I have enough gun depression. I think that would be for the next kill. So here, unfortunately, I don't have enough gun depression, so I'm using the breaking trick, where you can gain a bit of gun depression by playing with your suspension, by either breaking suddenly so that your gun will come down, or by reversing. And I jump to ultimately Cap C, so that was very fast and very easy battle, showing you that when a team goes in force to NB, there is simply no battle, and that they can even snipe the remaining enemies on C. I will have the time to take a bomber. As you notice on the map, the enemy realized that A and B were also on this map, and maybe decided to spawn there because they were afraid of spawning on C. I have no idea. Anyway, I killed four of them. Obviously, this enemy team was extremely weak, and obviously paid for it, but I think that was a good illustration to show you again the importance of A and B, and that fighting on C is totally irrelevant. So I thank you for watching, and I hope that this two gameplays and the tutorial will help you to deal with this beautiful map. See you soon on the battlefield. À bientôt sur le champ de bataille.